southwest, and Saturday's map indicates plenty of hot weather continuing for much of the Southland. Here's the jet stream dipping right across southern Nevada. You're going to see showers and thunderstorms from the Rockies moving into the Plain States, and also some more wet weather stretching throughout the Mid-Atlantic.
Was shot by storm chaser and meteorologist Gene Moore. Hail is not uncommon, but video of it is. Not many people want to risk their cameras or their cranium standing in a hailstorm. These chunks of ice can travel at as much as 50 miles an hour and can weigh up to a pound and a half. $300 to $700 million a year in crops alone are destroyed by hail in this country. Since hail is created by thunderstorms, you might think Oklahoma gets a lot of it, and you'd be right. Anywhere from 2 to 8 days a year, hail will fall somewhere in Oklahoma. But the place that gets the most hail, averaging more than 8 days a year, is right at the Colorado, Wyoming, and Nebraska borders, at the eastern edge of the Rocky Mountains. Oh, and about the photographer, Gene Moore. We don't have a picture of him, but you'll know him when you see him. He's the one with a big lump on his head.
North, south, east, or west, don't leave home without the Regional Traveler's Report. Current conditions and satellite views, region by region, including Alaska, help you plan your trip. Watch the Regional Traveler's Report twice every hour on the Weather Channel. Time now for travel weather. Forecast for all your destinations from city to city and sea to sea.
The city-by-city report includes Atlanta, Georgia, where variable clouds and a possibility of thunderstorms will be the story today. Look for a high, however, of only 82 degrees, a little below what they've been having. In Washington, also, temperatures are going to be depressed by the cloud cover, mostly cloudy with a high of only 73 in Washington today. Pittsburgh will have sunny skies, but they'll be under the influence of that dome of cool high pressure, so a high of only 70 degrees. New York is going to have the clouds most of the day. Temperatures should only make it to about 68 degrees. While in Omaha, Nebraska, look for thunder showers. They've got one right now, as a matter of fact. 79 degrees, the predicted high. In Dallas, Texas, it's going to be sunny. The Texas sun is going to shine with a vengeance. Should hit about 95 degrees. In Houston also, a mostly sunny day with a high of 91.
When minor arthritis pain says you can't, Encaprin's micrograin medicine lets you say,
I can.
With Encaprin, you can. Read why in your favorite magazine. Encaprin's a better way to treat arthritis because its aspirin micrograins bring hours of unsurpassed relief in a way that's safer for your stomach than plain or buffered aspirin. When arthritis pain says you can't, Encaprin lets you say,
I can.
Remember, Encaprin lets you say,
I can.
I can.
The first English colony in America to survive was Jamestown, Virginia, founded in 1607, but it almost did not. A relief fleet was sent from England in 1609 to rescue the suffering colony, but in July, a hurricane scattered the fleet. All the ships except one limped into Jamestown during the next few weeks. The flagship, Sea Venture, carrying the new governing officials of Virginia, was missing and presumed lost. Actually, it had run before the south winds east of the hurricane and was wrecked on the reefs of an uninhabited island. All were saved. Food and water were plentiful, enabling the group to winter there. The island was Bermuda. Fashioning two tiny sailing vessels from the wreck of the Sea Venture and some Bermuda cedar, they sailed to Jamestown the following spring. There they were welcomed as if they had risen from the dead. Plans to abandon the colony were scrapped. An interesting historical footnote is that the wreck of the Sea Venture provided the background for Shakespeare's play, The Tempest.
The Weather Channel, in cooperation with Prudential Bates Securities, reports on agricultural weather and related futures prices weekday mornings at 7:17 and 8:17 and evenings at 7:17 and 8:17 Eastern Time. It's an outlook for the most important weather elements affecting agriculture and livestock, along with closing futures prices. The Agricultural Commodity Report, brought to you by Prudential Bates Securities, the investment firm with rock-solid resources that's leading the way to the future. Prudential Bates, follow a leader.
Here's our regional traveler's report. First, the entire national map, and we'll break it down into smaller segments for you. Cool, clear weather across the Great Lakes. Still drizzly along the coast of southern New England, back down through Islip, the reporting light rain. Light rain scattered on down around Dover and Delaware, offshore from around Sandy Hook and Red Bank, however. Some fog is to be found across West Virginia, a little light rain too around Beckley. Visibility's up through here very good. Albany reporting 35 miles visibility, Caribou 30 miles up into Maine. Rain in the central parts of Alabama back into Mississippi and on across the river into parts of Arkansas. Some rain along the Savannah River Valley in Georgia. To the west, though, no precipitation in the vicinity of this low and this trough moving across Texas. Little fog up in the vicinity of Garden City in Kansas. But to the north and to the west, rain scattered, light rain, and scattered, widely scattered, Boise, Idaho, back on over into the, around Arcata in California, north to about the mouth of the Columbia River. But widely scattered rains, and that looks like that's going to be the story pretty well through the day. There's a fair amount of rain on the southern Alaskan coast with this low, and bands of rain back across the Aleutians. Temperatures right now 49 at Juneau, 56 at Fairbanks, 46 degrees is the story at Anchorage, and here's your local weather.
This is the Weather Channel. Coming up right after your local forecast, we'll have more weather information from across the nation, right here on the Weather Channel.
The heat. Win a 7-day all-expense-paid luxury cruise up the cool coast of Alaska as a guest on a Holland America West Tours ocean liner winding through 1,000 spectacular miles of the Great Inside Passage. It's the grand prize in the Emerson Quiet Cool Beat the Heat sweepstakes. Win one of 21 first prize Emerson Quiet Cool room air conditioners, 6,100 BTUs of quiet cooling efficiency with an energy saver switch and a watt watcher for more cooling on less electricity. Or you can beat the heat with a tough 30-quart Pepsi-Cola cooler or a Pepsi headband visor. Here's how to enter. Twice every hour, we'll tell you the hottest daily temperature in the nation. To qualify, you must write the contest day number, city, and temperature on a postcard or the back of an envelope and send it to Emerson Quiet Cool, care of the Weather Channel, Post Office Box 93365, Atlanta, Georgia, 30318. We'll have drawings from all the correct daily entries. Enter once or every day and win a 7-day Alaskan cruise in the Emerson Quiet Cool Beat the Heat sweepstakes on the Weather Channel.
Time now for the weather and you, with the weather's effects on you, your health, and your lifestyle.
Good morning, everybody. Hot weather is in store for a good deal of the southeast, especially the southwest, where some spots will top out at 100 degrees this afternoon. Temperatures will be pretty pleasant across much of the northeast. Very chilly this morning. Some spots across upstate New York and northern Vermont drop below freezing. So, yes, we are expecting some pretty chilly temperatures, but they should be in the 60s and 70s later on this afternoon. So plenty of sunshine. A beautiful day is in store for you. Southwest, too, we'll see some real hot weather. And, of course, those dew point temperatures are rather high throughout much of the southeast and the Mississippi Valley and the Plain States. But notice Oklahoma, Texas, southern Louisiana, those dew point temperatures will be in the 70s for today. And that combined with those afternoon temperatures in the 80s and 90s are going to make it feel extremely uncomfortable if you're going to be outdoors doing any kind of work across much of the Southland. Extreme danger area across the Texas Big Bend, where some spots again will top out at 100 degrees or higher. Of course, much of the Southwest, severe area in effect from southern Arizona across Texas into northern Louisiana. And just exercise extreme caution throughout a good deal of the Great Plains into the southeastern portion of the country. Again, very high dew point temperatures combined with high afternoon temperatures are going to make it feel extremely uncomfortable, much warmer than it really is. Air stagnation, no large-scale areas expected across the country for today, but we do have high concentration levels of tree pollen reported from the Great Lakes into the New England region, and mold spores seem to be pretty high across a good deal of the southeast and also the Northern California coastline. Some of this data has been supplied to the Weather Channel by Multidata.
It's time to get out and enjoy the weather. And the Weather Channel helps you plan all your outdoor activities with recreation weather. Get conditions in the water and on the beach with the Boat and Beach Report. A forecast for conditions at the stadium, on the greens, and on the courts in sports weather. Extended forecasts for the week ahead and the weekend. A must-see for planning work or play. And to get the very most from your outdoor fun, a recreation weather extra. Don't miss recreation weather every hour on the Weather Channel.
The Agricultural Commodities Report is sponsored by Prudential Base Securities, the investment firm with rock-solid resources that's leading the way to the future. Prudential Base Securities. Follow a leader. The actual precipitation in the past 24-hour period indicates some heavy amounts across South Dakota and North Dakota, inch to 2 inches in some spots. And, of course, we also had some heavy rainfall amounts across portions of the northeast from the mid-Atlantic coast into southern New England, some spots an inch and a half there, too. Also across Missouri and northern Arkansas, you too picked up a quarter to a half an inch in many spots, and locally an inch in some of those thunder showers. We're expecting another inch to accumulate across a good deal of the northern plains as well as the upper Mississippi Valley today, in addition to what you've already received. Now, the upper airflow pattern for Friday does indicate another system developing across the state of Nevada, and also showers and thunderstorms moving into much of the Great Lakes. You can see that will continue to spread eastward. Of course, hot weather is the outlook Thursday through Friday, and that could cause a lot of stress to livestock across much of the Southland. And that will continue to be in the forecast throughout Sunday, with showers and thunderstorms moving from the Plain States actually into the lower Ohio Valley and also into the northeastern portion of the country. The system in the west is going to spread widely scattered showers and thunderstorms also from Nevada into the Four Corner region. Now let's take a look at yesterday's prices.
Some investors have learned it's hard to make money these days just following the herd. They've seen that old-fashioned techniques don't always seem to work anymore. And that listening to yesterday's ideas isn't enough in today's financial markets. More and more, the ambitious investor is following the firm with rock-solid resources that's leading the way to the future. Prudential Base Securities. Follow a leader.
Time now for travel weather. Weather information for your business or travel plans.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Gay Dawson. Thanks for joining me. And hello to Don Bussin.
Hello, Gay. I feel great today.
Well, you always do.
Well, I look like $1 million, too, huh?
I'm
also very humble, as you can see. Hey, Gay, you were asking about the roads and travel conditions. Well, check this out. You know, there could be severe thunderstorms. Could be. There's some big ones up there even right now. We're talking about eastern South Dakota and getting into a little bit of Iowa, Sioux City, Iowa, thundering, Sioux Falls, South Dakota.